While Need for Speed Underground, Underground 2, Most Wanted and Carbon are all-time classics and still enjoyable games today, there are unfortunately no remakes or remastered of these games, and gamers are left with the original retail CDs or DVDs they may have stolen from back in the days. Hi, my name is Vodax Acherontic, and in today's video we will learn how to set up and run these games on Linux. By this, we will also apply various patches to these games to improve the user experience, such as no CD and widescreen fixes. Deja Vu. Prerequisites. Before we can install and run these games, we first need to ensure some prerequisites are met. First of all, I recommend installing bottles from Flathub to allow for easy management of Windows games on Linux. If you are unfamiliar with Flatpak and Flathub on Linux, feel free to check out my dedicated tutorial video on that topic. Install the games. In this video I will use Need for Speed Underground 2 as an example, but the setup process for the first Underground, Most Wanted and Carbon are the same. First of all, if you haven't done this already, we want to create a new bottles environment to run our games. For this, open up bottles and create a new environment by clicking on the plus icon in the top left of the main window. Supply a name and choose Gaming as the environment preset. Then hit create and wait for bottles setting everything up. Now it is time to mount our image files of these games or to instance the original retail disks. In this video, I will use image files as my system does not have a disk drive. I highly recommend to take a look at my dedicated tutorial video on how to manage disk images on Linux, as it also covers some troubleshooting if applications are not able to access disks or images properly. Also, I recommend to insert or mount all disk images beforehand, because some of these games ship with two disks and both are required for the installation. Therefore, I recommend to mount all images in advance to speed up the setup process, because we do not need to swap disks during the installation. After mounting the disks or images, make sure to restart bottles so Flatpak will grant proper access to them. Next, enter the environment where you want the game to be installed by selecting it. Click on Run Executable and navigate to the mounted disks image and select the setup.exe of the game and click on Run. Then walk through the installer as you would do on Windows and complete the setup assisted. If Bottles does not list the newly installed game after the installer has finished its job, we can manually refresh the view by selecting the three dots in the upper right corner and choose Search for new programs. If the game still does not show up, we can manually add it by clicking on Add Shortcuts. This will open up a file chooser right inside the Bottles environment. In here, navigate to drive_c, program files x86, EA Games, followed by the game you have installed. Then select the main executable and hit Add. As the application shortcut now shares the same name as the executable, we might want to rename it. For this, click on the three dots next to the shortcut and choose Rename. Then provide a better name. No worries, this will not rename the executable itself. If you are using the image-based approach, the game cannot be launched yet, as the ISO format does not carry over all aspects of the secure disk DRM this game requires. Using the physical disk, however, will work fine and we could already run the game. No CD fix. This is not about cracking games, but rather for users who own a legit copy but lack a disk drive in their system but still want to be able to play them. Therefore, in order to not always require the physical disks, I recommend applying the no CD fix. Simply download the fix from Game Copy World, all links can be found inside the video description. After downloading the required fix, unpack the archive. Then, inside Bottles, click on the three dots in the upper right corner and choose Browse Files. This will open up the Bottles environment inside your local file browser. Navigate to the location where the game is installed. By default, this is drive_c, program files x86, EA Games, followed by the game you have installed. Next, copy and paste the game executable from the no CD fix into the game directory. Overwrite or rename the original game executable as you wish. Widescreen fix. As a next step, I recommend installing the widescreen fix. Simply download the correct fix for your game from GitHub using the links in the video description. After downloading the fix, unpack it and copy all of its containing files and directories into the installation path of the game. Next, open up Bottles and click on Settings. Scroll down until you read DLL Overrides and open it. Add a new entry called dInput8 and set it to Native, then Built-in. This step is required because the fix relies on a custom dInput8 DLL, which by default might not get picked up by Wine. Therefore, we tell it to first look for a DLL file next to the main executable, which is what Native means. If it could not be found, then it should use its own dInput8 DLL, which is what built-in means. Troubleshooting. While most of the time these steps are the same for all four games, there are a few occasions where some of them require some special tweaks. Need for Speed Underground 2. For Underground 2, we will require the no CD and the widescreen fix in order to be able to play the game without any physical or virtual disc. With just the no CD fix, we would still require a mounted disc image to play. Therefore, I recommend using both the no CD and the widescreen fix for this game. Need for Speed Most Wanted. For Most Wanted, we need to configure the widescreen fix, as by default the game UI might be misplaced. Therefore, if you want to play Most Wanted with the fix, you have to open up the scripts directory we copied into the game installed from the widescreen fix. Then, open the file nfsmostwanted.widescreenfix.ini with any text editor you like. Below main, change fixhut equals 1 to fixhut equals 0. This will keep the in-game user interface at the original 4:3 aspect ratio and might stretch it. But at least it is not off-screen and all elements can still be seen. Outro. That's it. With these steps you should have a pleasant gaming experience with Need for Speed Underground, Underground 2, Most Wanted 2005 and Carbon on Linux. I hope you found this video helpful and enjoy some street racing. But remember,
the moves that you and your crew do in the game are meant to stay in the game. In the real world, drive safe, obey the laws of the road, and always wear your seatbelt.